Eric. Eric, welcome to the next Salt 16, Salt TV 16. We're going to talk about 2016 six thrash albums that came out.
Minus one. Well, it came out in 2015.
Right. But it was 4/16.
Was it?
It was probably late 2015, so they put it out so everybody could listen to, you know, I guess to say, it better own up to this.
Right.
Everybody else is better own up to this. So. And I think everybody did a pretty good job of that. So. But, yeah. What are you drinking this week, Eric?
I've got the Dead World Zombie Soda.
Who makes that?
Dead World.
I forget the word.
It's horrifyingly good, it says. It's orange flavored, as you can probably tell by the color. It just says a word to rumor. It doesn't say who makes it. It just says Dead. Dead World. Caprice? Is that the... Anyway. Kind of a cool bottle.
The cap's even cool on that one.
Mm.
There's a place down in Oklahoma called Pops. You haven't seen that. I haven't shown that to you yet. Super cool place. My kind of place. I'll pick these up at. I'm drinking some Martian soda. I still can't see that one very well. Taste the abduction.
Plum flavored.
Plum flavored. They could come up with a better alien blood flavored or something.
All right.
This is really cool because it's like, you can't tell in here, but it looks like it's got metal in it. It looks
right.
Like liquid metal, like
right.
Some kind of silverish purple.
It's like something you'd put in your car engine.
Yeah.
Fuel additive.
Exactly. That is what it looks like. Almost diet, but more like candy flavored than diet. You know how like some candy tastes like flatter than pop does. It doesn't taste great necessarily, I guess maybe. It tastes more like alien blood. But Martian soda.
It tastes like abduction.
Well, I can go for some abduction then. Pretty good. See if you can find that somewhere online. I can't read the cap, so I don't know where. I think it only comes down when the aliens come down and distribute the rear. So, but anyway, what's up first?
First album, we're going to go in alphabetical order, is Anthrax, For All Kings. Let you do the honors, it's yours.
They put a lot into, probably more than any other band. The labels have been going nuts on their packaging to sell anything other than digital, you know.
Right.
And they went all out on this one, probably more than any other of these albums, maybe, but this one's, well, yeah, well, this one looks cool, though.
Right.
This is really wild, slip cover on there, and it's got kind of a gloss, a silvery gloss on there, kind of like they must have used some of the alien
abduction.
Alien, pop stuff on there.
Some full set of lyrics.
How's this stack up to what they've been doing lately?
Get that out. You know, what's the first disc in it? Yeah, this isn't bad. It's not a bad album. Very similar to Worship Music. It's not, I wouldn't say it's the cream of the crop for Anthrax. Of course, I grew up on the stuff when it was original, the early stuff. Yeah, 86, 85, 87. So, you know, that's that's what I go back to whenever any of these bands put an album out. I go back to, is it as good as XYZ? This album is good. It's very listenable. But it's very similar to worship music. If you bought worship music, see the same color for the kind of pink. Don't see that one. I mean, it's got Joey on it for on vocals, and for me that was the big deal breaker when I picked up worship music. And why I would pick this one up is because Joey's back on vocals. Wasn't a big fan of John Bush. But the playing's superb. The production's really good on it. Most of the songs are pretty catchy. There's a couple of songs that really didn't do too much for me. But overall, I'd say, you know, if I was going to rate it, I'd say 7 out of 10. But what do you think?
This one was, out of the 6 albums, this one was kind of like Anthrax might would be. They've always kind of had a little bit of fun in there, you know, jumping around with the rap groups and stuff. And that's still, maybe it's just in my head that way, but because this is more serious than like some of that early goofy stuff, you know, overall, but it still has more the fun sound, and I think that's just their nature. More bouncy, fun. But all of these bands are really, I don't know if stepped up, but stepped up to the plate anyway, you know, to thrash out. You know, nobody's right. Taking a nap, you know.
Right.
And so it's, I think of the 6, this is kind of the most fun to listen to, if you're looking, that's what I'm looking to hear.
Yeah.
And, you know, because in the Bush days, a lot of that's real more, all of it's real more serious, you know. It sounds like, you know, like the more serious thrash, what am I thinking of? Anyway, but because he's got a tough voice, not that bouncy voice that Bill Nye had. But it's the most fun to listen to. This one, you know, I had to get the pink. I really don't know how many pressings there are of this. The blue one was cool, but I had the choice to get this really super metal color. And you know, how is it gonna pass up this ultra metal color with the, you know, giant pink pentagram etched in the fourth side. Now,
is that etched? I didn't know that.
Yeah, the Anthrax A on the
right.
Evil. I thought that was awesome. I don't know how limited run this. I hope this is a limited run, but this is probably still available. Probably because people are too afraid.
Right. Who would be afraid of a pink pentagram?
I'll wear a pink shirt. I'm man enough. If you can't tell, we both have a cold. That's why we didn't do this last week, which you wouldn't know that, but other than it's taken, what, since June that we did the last video?
July.
And,
yeah, this is right at the end of June.
This is one of those colds that's never ending, unfortunately, it's, I think, but, so.
Anyway, overall, good album, bordering on great. Like I said, if you liked worship music, very similar in sound. If you're just a diehard Bush fan, when Anthrax was them, you probably wouldn't like it. If you're like me, you know, I want to hear Among the Living or Spreading the Disease. You know, to me, that's the cream of the crop there.
I'd like to know, tell me in the comments, if you're a Bush Anthrax fan as opposed to Belladonna. I could see that being the case, but I've never heard of anybody being a Bush fan over, you know, would only prefer those albums. I'm a Bush fan. You know, not to where I can't remember the dadgum band name.
Armored Saint.
Grief. Yeah, I'm a big fan. I'm your biggest fan. But I like those albums too, which I've heard are disappearing for some reason. Like embarrassed or
it's your soda fault.
I don't know, but
alien abductions.
Been abducted. But I liked them, and I don't know. I don't know that Anthrax to me has ever had a bad album. Because I'm a Bush fan.
Right. So.
Not over Belladonna. I prefer Belladonna, I think, but I like those. Anyway, good album.
Up next we have,
I'm gonna get this,
Death Angel, The Evil Divide. Pretty wicked looking. They're using their classic logo there, I think. Got the moth and the skull there. There you go.
Now, that's one thing I was trying to remember. In my glasses. But I couldn't remember. I can't remember the name of the artist who did that. There's a tattoo artist who did the cover. Any Death Angel fan by now knows, I'm sure. But a real different cover for him than the frightening bloody wolves and everything.
Right, the last few album covers.
This is a understated, but still. I don't know, maybe that's creepy to you, but, you know, it's cool tattoo art. I got the, there's various versions of this one you can get. They were nice enough on this one to actually put a black lined slip sleeve to go with the black, I mean the white, I just thought the white version went well with the cover, but the, this one has a etching also.
White on white etching.
That
it's really hard
probably
to see.
Shows up a lot better on the gray. So if I were to get one that you really want white, I'd get the gray or the black, if you care. That the etching shows up. But that would, you know, that would display pretty cool. It's pretty cool etching. Which like I say, you can only see in certain light on this, but that looks rather cool. They've been doing a lot of real cool custom labels, which is awesome. You know, instead of, I've got the Casablanca label, you know, the boring Electra. So that's kind of cool, you know. Been going all out on the art.
Well, musically, I'd say this is, it's not bad. It's pretty run-of-the-mill. I say that. It's a thrash album. It's got a lot of thrash overtones to it. Again, for me, if I want to hear Death Angel, though, I want to go back to either the Ultraviolets or Frolic Through the Park. To me, those are the two classics. The Ultraviolets, I think, is 30 years old this year. Can you believe that?
That's crazy.
30, yeah. It's 1987. That would have been 30 years, right?
It's been a lot in 30 years.
Right. But it's not a, again, it's not a bad album, but it's pretty run-of-the-mill, I would say. It's pretty straightforward as far as the song and the tempos and the song writing and the production. Production to me was a little thin.
It was produced by
not horribly thin,
a primo guy in Florida. A new guy, he's pretty new.
Yeah.
It's real crazy. He's into metal, but he's been producing a lot of screamo stuff.
Ha.
It was demoed at Testament Studios.
Oh really?
So that's where they started out. You know, I was in the practice place.
Pardon me.
So, you know, I don't know how much, I don't know if that's what you're hearing, any of that, you know.
Could be. It's not as, it's not heavy.
Not as violent sounding.
Not as heavy, per se. You know, the thing for me is you know, especially like I said, on the Ultraviolets and Frog Through the Park, there's a lot of different variations. There's a lot of, you know, there was this part and that part, and they kind of meshed them all together. And this album here, like I said, it wasn't bad, but it was pretty consistent, just ching, 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 all the way through. You know, it wasn't. It was. There was no. You know, the one hit, you could say maybe Bored. They had. You know, it was really.
Yeah, I don't hear any.
Almost kind of jazzy, funky, almost, to, and not
right. And this is not that.
No,
Death Angel.
No, it's not that
it's
at
not
all.
Not that, and.
And not to, like I said, not to say it's bad.
There's no, I don't remember any hits on that. Anything that's memorable.
Yeah, I think that was the big thing was you listen to it and you go,
oh yeah, that's consistent.
It was consistent and it's not bad, but it's not something where you go, man, I really like that song. I want to hear that song again.
Right.
It's just, yeah, that's good.
But like you said, it's not a bad album.
No.
It's just not the first one to listen to if you hadn't heard them. You definitely, if you want to hear the latest Death Angel has been, you know, some of that might be member changes. There's a good chance of that because I can't recall exactly that point, but the last two are more thrashy than if you're looking for something more violent sounding than this, if you're looking for violent thrash, you know, but yeah, Death Angel is always, you always expect it to sound like the first album that you like, which is going to be the first album.
album, whatever.
But really, they do sound, actually they sound more mature than those albums, you know.
Well, like, they were real young.
Most, right, like most would.
They were real young. When those two albums came out, some of them were teenagers.
Right, but that would make it more experimental, you know,
right.
And these aren't experimental, these are just, you know, mature.
Hey! <You know. laughs> So is my grandpa.
But actually, you know, none of these albums, are, nobody's laying down on any of these, you know, it's consistent, it's just too consistent.
Right.
So.
Very, very consistent.
Yeah. Well, Death Angel, The Evil Divide.
Up next, we have
the bottom of that's coming out.
Megadeth, Dystopia, on picture disc. Pulling it out. They just want to leave it in there.
This one came out with a.
It's
falling. This came out on red, which I'm pretty sure is still available. And so that's kind of cool. They made I'm not sure how many they made of these, but I was able to find this super ultra cheap. The Dystopia, Megadeth Dystopia.
It's actually a pretty cool album cover.
But I found this.
Very sci-fi-ish.
Yeah, they had like three different versions of this, I think. There was at least black and red, and I didn't even know there was a picture disc until recently, and I found this one. I stole this one. This was not little. This was so cheap. It sounds fine as a picture disc. There's no noise in it. It sounds great. It sounds as good as any of the others. And they didn't split this one up, so it's all on one for one disc. I still like to have the red version, but nevertheless. But it's like we were talking about earlier. It's they're not laying down either.
I'm not the world's biggest Megadeth fan. I mean, honestly, I've not really enjoyed anything seriously since probably Peace Sells. I mean, that's. I don't know, that ages me, but this album is actually pretty decent. It's very, very thrashy. A lot more so than the last few albums. It's very, again, it's very consistent, but it's just not straight down the board consistent. I mix it up a little bit, but Dave sounds great. The musicianship sounds great. Drums. I mean, the whole shebang sounds great on it. Like I said, again, very thrashy if you're into that sort of thing. I grew up on 80s thrash, you know, so that's what I take.
I'm a more of a, I'm typically more, gonna lean more towards Megadeth than Anthrax.
Right.
And you probably lean more towards Anthrax than...
Back in the day, yeah.
Yeah. And, yeah, as far as our history. And there's plenty of noodling on here. And to me, that's what makes this one of all these sound the most metal.
Right.
Than thrash. Not band, but, at, you know, addition to the thrash. Because these always had more noodling going on. But it's super heavy. You know, you got Chris Adler from Lamb of God on drums. And so you got a lot of power coming out of this,
right,
out of this album.
Right.
And
again, Dave sounds great. I have a little bit of an issue with some of his vocals in the past. A little whiny for me.
And he has just enough of that creepy, you know, silly whine in this to where it's, it just sounds like Dave.
But it's not obnoxious.
No, not at all. Not on this. If it was all ever obnoxious,
right?
You know, I thought it was funny.
To me, it didn't do a lot.
Kind of creepy, funny, you know.
Not to say that I don't like bands that have similar vocals, because I have and I do. Just, I don't know. There's something about his vocals on some of the stuff. Just,
it's very different.
But this, he sounds pretty good on this. I mean, this album's pretty good. I would, if you're a Megadeth fan, it's definitely a must buy.
Well, if you like it, then definitely.
Right.
Because he's
been, right, because I'm very picky.
Questionable stuff, you know. He made a lot of changes. He made a lot of changes in the last year. He's coming up with this. What is he selling? The bassist. He's got coffee coming out, and he's got his own wine or something. And so, you know, they're busy people, you
right?
Know? And they're not just like, you know, sitting around doing anything. And so that kind of shows in the music too to me. They're to make band changes on purpose, because you want to do something certain with your album. That shows they put something into this one. So definitely worth picking up for a thrash fan. You don't even have to only be a Megadeth fan to me, I don't think. I think it really...
I would agree with that.
It's a good album. And I don't know how many of these made, but you might find a picture disc out there. I don't know. I think it was the only one I saw on Discogs, so I didn't even know it was available until a couple weeks ago, actually.
Yeah.
But the red one's available on the Megadeth site. I'm sure they must have printed a bunch of those. So, on red. Red's cool. So that's Megadeth Dystopia.
Okay, guys. Here we have the Metallica album box set. You see that? That thing.
That is nuts.
Right. They,
you gotta be a true Metallica fan.
Right.
You know what I mean? There's no bigger Metallica fan than me to shell out almost $70 for a record.
Set of records.
Could have been a record.
Right. Right. Just,
you know, I mean, there's no need for this. Well, to me, it's like, okay, you guys are going to complain about us not making a record forever. Well, then we're going to give you the kitchen sink.
Right. Right.
There's actually a kitchen sink in here, which is very handy because I needed a new one. And I actually don't even care for the art very much. Everybody's saying it looks like Crowbar, and there's another one that has a similar style. And Crowbar is like, cool. Listen to our albums.
Right.
You know? And they went all out with that theme, but I don't know, they could have done more if they're going to make this much of a packaging. That's just my thoughts on the artwork. It's just weird looking to me. It's not
right.
It's It's not metal looking or anything to me. It's just, but it's modern metal to me. I don't listen to much modern metal. And so
yeah,
that's what this looks like, is modern, the modern metal thing. It's like Christmas.
Whee!
You know, this is, these will always remain in this little bag since I, which might make one of you two of you mad, but some of these I wouldn't wear, even if I were wearing buttons, but actually I have some in my car, so. And this is just a, this is the, I'll go ahead and say it, to the top of my head. This is really the best part of the album. To me. This is all I would have really needed. I like this CD the most, really.
Really.
It's got a Ronnie Rising medley, which is really like the deep purplish, you know, rainbow. The rainbow, the early Ronnie James Dio, from Rainbow and stuff.
Say it slowly.
And that is cool to me, because it's very, you know, that shows to me that they're a fan of the old stuff, and you know, more obscure stuff, because that's relatively obscure, you know, especially for anybody new listening to Metallica. So that was really cool that they did that. And Helpless, one of the cooler Garage Days.
Mm-hmm. Oh, why? Other than the first, what, three?
Hit the Lights, you know.
It was an Iron Maiden song, too, isn't it? And the Iron Maiden, Remember Them All?
Yeah. And I can't read this, so.
Here.
Very well enough.
Helpless Live, Hit the Lights, The Four Horsemen, Ride the Lightning, Fade to Black, Jump in the Fire, For Whom the Bells Toll, Creeping Death, and Metal Militia. Those are all live tracks. And then,
how long has it been since the last album?
I don't know. I haven't.
Has it been 10 years? It hasn't been 10 years, has it? Has it been 10 years since anybody would listen to them? A lot of people?
Oh, sure, there's a lot of people that will listen.
That's enough for someone to go from a 10-year-old to a 20-year-old, or
right,
to not know. So,
right,
you know, that's cool to put stuff on here, like, listen to this.
Oh, and you think Metal stuff, Metal, you know? Militia and Creeping Death, that's from 84?
Yeah.
Right? I mean, that's 30-plus years now. I was a teenager when that stuff came out, you know?
Yeah, so it's cool to, you know, that's a cool listen. And to me, that was like the best part. Not that that album's bad, because it's not really a bad album. But it's got these, you know, for anyone who wants to cover their walls with weird, almost boring to me. I'm sorry, these are almost boring to me. Art. I mean, it's...
I like that one.
It's
kind of funny, but
it's not a bad idea. It's not bad art. It's just, I don't know. I've gotten so much good album art this year that this is just, you know, I'm not impressed. It's smart, I guess. I don't know. Somebody needs to tell me why they like it, you know. I'm sure there's, I see with a theme.
Yeah.
You know, I like a minimalist theme. I think I'm just not expecting it from Metallica is what it is, you know?
Yeah.
So, and it's, I don't know, it's done well for a minimalist, you know, focus on this design. It's all focused on this design, you know?
For the back there.
That it's
actually cool.
You know, a good idea. Except that, I don't know, you know, they spent some money on this. This is...
They spent a lot of money on it.
Some effort put into this, even though it's a real minimalist art, you know. I got the... this box set comes with colored, which match the colors of the album.
Dark blue?
Yeah, with the, it's got a marble in it.
A little bit of marbling, yeah.
It looks black until you take it out and look at it. It's a really super dark blue marble in it. And that's cool. But the, and they're nice in slip case, of, you know, slip sleeves.
Want to light through?
See the glows in the darts?
See that?
So that's the blue one, and these aren't too short. There's three songs on a side, so that's kind of, you know, that's cool. It's not as obnoxious as some of them we'll talk about in a minute. This one's a real mellow metal yellow. But just, to me, that again, it's like, they're not talking about slime, it's just yellow. What does yellow have to do with Metallica? I don't know, it's just
lightning, kinda, I don't know, maybe ride the lightning?
Yeah. I don't know. It's, it has a separate lyrics sheet also. Now this one, what was the deal about, I think everybody knows, about how this was written, guitarist said he lost all of his music on his phone, had all his music on his phone, and said he lost all of it. He lost his phone and lost all the music for the album. So all of this has none of his music on there.
Do we hear him?
Yeah.
I don't know.
So, you know.
I didn't hear that story.
That's a controversy out there. You guys can discuss amongst yourselves. But three more on each side there, which is cool. So it's, you know, are you hearing, what difference do you think the bassist has had on their sound? Suicidal tendencies, right?
I think it's, yeah, Robert Trillo. Who he was with originally.
Any effect?
He's played around. You know, overall, listening to this album, it's better than anything they put out in the last few years, in my opinion. It's like everything else. If I want to hear Metallica, I'm going to go back to Master Puppets, you know, Ride the Lightning, Kill 'Em All, and Justice for All. This album's good. It's my personal feelings were that from start to finish, by the time the album ended, I was pretty bored. I mean, it's consistent.
Right.
My main problem with Metallica in the last few years has really been James Hetfield and his singing. I don't care for it.
Country singing?
Whatever you want to call it, it's just, you know, and I'm not saying that he doesn't sing in Ride the Lightning or Master of Puppets or Garage Days or even Kill 'Em All, you know, he does sing there, but I don't know, he's done something, he's either taken vocal lessons and he's trained his voice. It just, something about it just annoys me. And musically, this album is a lot thrashier than anything. Yeah, it wasn't metal with a question mark. Metallica. It was very thrashy in a lot of the songs. I don't know, but just by, like I said, by the end of the album, after hearing however many songs are on here, 12? How many songs?
Yeah.
I think it's 12 songs. By the end of the album, I was just like, okay. And I know, you know, Master of Puppets or whatever, and Justice for All runs just as long, if not as longer, and I can listen to all that and enjoy every minute of it, where this, I was just...
Well, these are what is, I don't know if it's a modern thing, but these are, I differentiate to me. There's music, people want to listen to music, and some people want to listen to songs. And this is for people who want to listen to songs. And, you know, like that first single that came out, you know, that I don't...
Molly for the Flames?
No.
Is that it?
What was the first one?
I don't know. What was the first one I heard?
Hardwired, you know? I don't need to hear what he's saying, personally. So I don't want to hear that. But it's a song, and he's saying something, you know, we're all... I don't need to hear that. But that's what some people want to hear. That's all they care about is, yeah, just tell me something, you know...
Metal.
Yeah, you know, but on those earlier metal, on those earlier albums, Creeping and Wan and all those, they're playing a lot of music in a lot of those. And so you're like, some of it you're listening to for the music, not just a song.
Right.
You know, and this is all a bunch of songs. And so they're all hitting you real hard, just a hard hitting song. And like a lot of people, that's what they're listening, look, you know, that's what I listen to 98.9 The Rock or whatever, but... A song.
Right.
And this is what this is a whole lot of really hard hitting songs.
Right. And maybe that's part of the digital age where you can just go buy a song now too.
Yeah.
As opposed to a whole album. You know what I'm saying? Because when growing up, you know, you went out and guilty, I like to listen to anything before I buy it because I don't want to waste my money, honestly. But nowadays, you know, you go, oh, well, I like that song, but I don't want the rest of the album, so I'll just buy that song and whatever. Another thing, like you're saying, is maybe to go with that theme is when they released this album, actually before they released this album, they put every song out on YouTube. They released it on YouTube. And, you know, if you go back a few years when they sued Napster and was having a fit because their music was out there illegally. You know, and he took, it was Lars Ulrich, took that guy from Napster to court. You know, I'm not saying I'm for pirating music, but having your music out there on the internet is not always necessarily a bad thing because it gives people a chance to hear it, and then they can decide whether or not they want to buy it or not. And I do that with a lot of stuff that I buy now. I'll try to see if I can find, at least listen to part of it, and go, okay, yeah, I'll spend the money on that. And maybe that's what they've done here is they've written a bunch of songs. So, you know, casual fan Joe Blow here, he can go out and go, okay, I like that song because they cuss a lot in it, or but that's how I'm feeling right now. So I'm going to buy that song, but I don't want the rest of the album.
Right.
So I'll just buy that song, or I'll, you know, or if I'm in the mood, I can, and if I want some one of the other songs, I can go buy it. Again, wasn't a bad album. It's better than Load or Reload or whatever that Satan Anger thing.
They had a lot to live up to at that point, and people like the Black Album, Saint Anger, you know.
And I like the Black Album. It's definitely not my favorite, but
and you know, this they had a lot to live up to on this one.
Right.
I mean, you. You doom yourself if you name your band Metal.
Right.
We are Metal. I mean, you better always be Metal.
Right.
So, you know, one of the best things I like lately about Metallica is, have you seen James Hetfield's cars? That's my thing. I like his cars way better than this album. And this album's pretty good. So, you know, if any of my money's going to those cars, I hope you're enjoying your cars because I need an interior of mine. I could have bought some seats for half the price of this, you know. Not half, you know, this could have been half the price of one of my seats, you know, in my car.
Nah, don't go blaming Metallica. You buy seats for your car.
Well, this is not going to come out very often in my shelf, so... I'm gonna complain about this. So this fourth one, that was the big. That came out what 2 years ago or something? Lord of Summer, and I was not impressed. I was like, they do better than that one song. Now this is a cool color.
Oh, the red, opaque red.
It's got all of these have like a smoke in them. That's a better word than marble. It's kind of smoke smoke in them. There's one song on each side. One of them is this is a bonus disc. So you get two bonus discs with this, a bonus LP and a bonus CD. And this comes on, I think, a two album. Otherwise, you just don't get this extra one. It has Lords of Summer on one side that came out a million years ago. And then I'll have to look at the cover to see what's on the other side of this. It's live, a live song. Hardwired Live.
Woo!
They're a big song that everybody's gonna, you know, go nuts to. Hopefully they'll sing first and get over with or something. Not a bad song, it's just not my kind of thing. You know, it's like, it's really hard for me to hear some people complain.
Right. Especially when you're a millionaire.
Millionaire. Somebody tell me why that, you know. And he's trying to say, we, you know, us in general, we're all
screwed.
You know. We don't need to encourage all these little snowflakes.
Snowflakes, buttercups.
It's not all that bad, people. Come on. Let's see. I want this first. You know, I got to keep these real pretty pictures,
yep,
you know, in good shape. So I can frame them. You know, that's cool packaging overall. Anything else we can say about...
Overall, not bad. Metallica. If you're a classic Metallica fan, you may dig it. Like I said, by the time I reached the end of the album, I was ready for it to be over. I'll just say that. It just kept kind of boring. And there's some there's some really good thrash parts.
It's like getting hit over a head with a brick over and over and over and over and over. Not just once. Or in the gut or on the shoulder. It's just a brick to the head over and over and over and over and over and over. Mm-hmm. You know? Like somebody shouting in your face the whole time.
Right. Oh, I don't mind that. I don't listen to plenty of music like that.
No, that's not what I mean, though. I mean, it's just... But, yeah, you know, I mean...
I was just bored by the time the album ended. I was just like, okay, if I'm going to listen to Metallica, I'll go back and listen to Master of Puppets or my favorite, actually, Garage Days Revisited, the original one.
It's just a bunch of good, hard, if that's what you're into, a bunch of good, hard metal songs. They didn't screw up on any of it in us.
No, production's fantastic on it.
And that was a worry for some. Right. And I would say that's another reason to maybe get the vinyl, because it's...
No Saint Anger... Whatever production that was.
It could be harsh, but this definitely could sound harsh.
So that Lulu thing they did with, what's his name?
Yeah. But anyway, that's Metallica. We spent a whole video on that one album.
All right. Now we're getting down to brass tacks here.
Probably gonna be at an hour.
Here we have Slayer's Repentless. Like we said at the beginning, this actually came out at the end of 2015, but there that is. It's got your typical Slayer imagery. One of the Slayer logos.
Jesus. You gotta have some kind of dead or dying Jesus on a Slayer.
Right.
Album,
and a pentagram. Mandatory. Blood. Fire. Yada, yada, yada. You know, it's Slayer. Have to have that. There's the inside, there's the cover, there's the back. I'm going to say, personally, overall, out of listening to all these, this was probably my favorite, even more so than Testament.
I would have to agree.
What can you say? It's Slayer. Slayer had been... And we were talking about it before we filmed the video. Slayer's been around since 82, 83?
I don't even know.
thing. When that first one came out, I think in 83, and I mean, they've been just consistent with their releases as far as sound, maybe not, you know, putting one out every year, but it's, I mean, when you go to buy a Slayer album, this is Slayer. You can listen to this, and equally, maybe not equally, because again, my favorite by them would have to be Rain and Blood. That's the classic thrash album from 86, I think, 85, 86. But you can listen to that, or you can listen to this and go, yeah, that's Slayer. Yeah. That's, I mean, that's
little difference.
They come out and punch you right in the face and leave the big burning pentagram in your forehead or whatever. Yeah.
There's not quite as defined a song as like Rain and Blood.
Yeah.
But
I would agree with that. Yeah.
They still do the same thing,
right,
overall, and
they do it excellent.
In a way, once again, I'd say, I don't really use the word mature. It's just like they know what they're doing, right, you know, and so they're not like trying to do something. They're not trying to have a hit. They're not trying to. They're just saying this. I mean, it's just beastly, you know. And you know, Repentless. They made a point of making a big deal of this album, went making a video with Treo, you know, that was, you know, that, and who else is in that? There's a few other people in there that are, that's a brutal, brutal video.
Yeah.
And that's a statement in itself, that video. And they, once again, you know, they've stepped up, and if anybody's got to step up,
right,
I mean, if anybody's gonna, you know, not be laying down, you know, these guys are not. These guys aren't relaxing any.
Right.
They're
like kind of like what you said about, you know, if you're gonna have metal in your name, like with Metallica. You know, when the name of your band is Slayer. I mean, you know, you're not having songs about unicorns and puppies.
They do have all the different aspects of that, all the various things that they've ever talked about,
right,
on this, and right, some of it's real cryptic, but it's got all of that. You know, one of the things that's kept me a lot of times from listening to Slayer a lot of times is that, you know, it just seems so anti-God, anti, you know, God hates us all and everything. They even reference that in here. And, you know, I don't know, I keep going back to, like I said, I was talking about before, you know, about it, not for it, and reading through all the lyrics, it's either real cryptic or leans towards about it, not for it. It's kind of hard to tell. And Repentless, I was like, come on, give me a break. But then when I started looking at it and what they're talking about and everything, there's two things he's talking about. One, he's like, I'm not apologizing, is really the main, what he's really saying is, I'm not apologizing for nothing, for what I'm doing, you know, for, not for what he's saying, but for his, you know, for anything, you know,
right,
which is a cool thing to do, you know, to just be like, you know, not laying down all the time, like, cowering, right, is basically what he's talking about. You know, the video, you know, what's
right,
going on there,
right,
it's like, so they give you these, you know, if you're not paying attention, you're giving it, you know, and some of that does incite violence. Some of it does incite violence to me in that way. Pride and Prejudice, I think, is an anti-racist song, racism song. But some of it does lean a little bit towards inciting violence. And, you know, like right now, people are wanting to hear that and be encouraged by that. But I don't know. I really kind of want to say neither here nor there, because we're talking about some music, and this, yeah, to me, I was pleasantly surprised or whatever, and I don't want to say that. I didn't really have any expectations.
Right.
But yeah, this one is the most enjoyable to listen to for, well, if you're trying to listen to any heavy thrash metal, this one is.
This is it here. This one here, set. This is what all these other bands' albums we're talking about. This beer's the standard beer.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, you know.
Right.
So if you're, like I said, if you're a Slayer fan, you've already got this. You know, it's in your rotation, and it's probably been in your rotation. I would recommend it. If you're looking for, like we said, heavy thrash, cryptic, violent themes. I just got to point out, Tom's got the most awesome beard. That is freaking awesome.
Better than Scott? This
guy. Oh, yeah. Much better.
Oh, you don't like that?
No.
That's the swallow the squirrel? Yes, and that's
it's real funny. Men. They've all got beards now, which is real funny men. To me. Which is funny.
They've got a beard, and they're probably guaranteed not wearing skinny pants.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, they've got the imagery going on. He looks like my uncle. Uncle Lee. Sorry. This nice, I mean, not super thick, but it's a nice, a lot of people are just using this slip. This is the way to do it. This is the old-fashioned way.
Old school.
Your record goes in the lyric sheet, you know? And it's got all those on there. This one's 60 minutes long. Put all on here, and it doesn't seem long. It doesn't seem long.
No. You can listen to it all and be like, right on. Right on.
I was expecting this to be a blood red, and it is, if you're talking about 1960s slasher film blood. That's why I don't know if they were doing that on purpose, but I thought that was funny. I was disappointed when I pulled it. I was like, that's not blood red, right. You know? Because I've got some that are like really rich, and I just thought that was kind of funny. It's like, well, this is like 60s slasher movie for it. So I actually paid. This was a FYE, I think, and so this is, I don't know how low the numbers are, but
store bought.
It was actually, if you go to the store, you're only going to find black. You got to order this thing. And from what I can tell. But it's not the label's color. It's just their own color, and a special color, special release. Order them all, look for them in special. A lot of the labels are putting out multi-colors, and I think this one, this probably has clear or something too, but I had to get the red.
Overall quality,
black is always no, but I don't know. I'm just having fun with the colors,
right?
In the last couple of years, you know,
right.
It's kind of cool since everybody's, you know, going nuts with the vinyl. But real well, good, great layout. Coloring is awesome. Great, I mean, that perfect color to me, and I like the semi-gloss, kind of flat.
Again, it's colors. It's Slayer, you know?
Yeah. Well, it's not goofy like the first few. It's still somewhat cartoonish. I think some of this is, I haven't looked into it, but I have a feeling they're like talking about their other albums or something. Because they mention them, and what this imagery looks like is from, I don't buy a lot of Slayer. I listen to what I have, you know. But God Hates Us All, whatever, real stupid art. No art. But that's the digital days. Right. But we're back to making, you know, artwork and to match the sound. And all over a great package. Yeah, definitely the first one of any of these to pick up. The first.
Right. All right.
Lastly, we have
Testament, Brotherhood of the Snake. personally, this is probably my second favorite. And I'm back in the 80s, my first thrash metal love was Anthrax. And then Testament came along, and Testament was my favorite for a good while. But this is pretty much, well, a return to form for them. I mean, they had some stuff there in the last few years. It's been okay, in my estimation. I think the last one I bought was, I think the last one previous to this one, Dark Roots of the Earth.
Yeah.
And it's not bad, but it's not something I listen to and I go, man, I want to hear that again. You know, again, you know, if I'm going to go back, I want to hear Testament's The Legacy or The New Order. But this album here is pretty fun. I'm going to have to say so myself.
I'll use the word solid this time.
Yeah.
Instead of consistent. I'd say solid, you know. It's definitely, I think you hear what it is. It was primarily Eric. From what I understand, Eric wrote this whole thing,
Peterson.
And they came in and, you know, of course, Chuck wrote the vocals for it and everything. And then everybody adds their thing, which they're all great musicians.
Right.
So anytime they're going to come in and add their thing,
right,
it's going to be good, you know. And I, that drummer, good grief. What was he saying the other day? I heard him talking the other day. But he's just bombastic. Got the greatest hair in the world. What's his name?
Gene Hoagland?
Yeah, Gene Hoagland. It's bombastic. And,
he is a very good drummer.
Steve Stornio from Alex Skolnick. Chuck sounds as great as, I mean, you know, having a health scare and everything. You know, he's come back, you know. I mean, he's been in fight mode for the last quite a few years, and I actually haven't gotten either one in the last two.
Yeah,
I mean, to. I showed this to Jordan, my youngest son, and I was like, wow, man, I really wasn't as. But when I first saw this art, I was like, what is that? I love the last album, you know, the artwork on it and all that. To me, that was a Testament album cover.
Right.
You know, it's on the poster, you know. And then they come out with this one that's like complete opposite direction. It's the same artist. And I was like, what is that? And Jordan's like, no, that's really super cool. So I was like, I guess it worked, you know. And it's got the overall theme, what they're trying to do is what they, I think Eric told Chuck, he's like, let's stop talking so about serious issues. Let's do something more outside of reality and, or, you know, something more bizarre or whatever. And so all this is a lot about, you know, he said he's reading a lot about aliens in the Bible and that kind of thing. So there's a lot of just weird, all kinds of conspiracy themes and that kind of stuff, and a lot of weirdness instead of, you know, serious personal issues or whatever. And so it kind of gets a dark theme, you know, mysterious theme or whatever going on this album. But once again, it doesn't have, you know, the song a lot of people are going to be crazy about, probably is a stupid marijuana song, but. The one that stood out to me the most was the Seven Seals, which is about, they're just talking about a part in the Book of Revelation. And that's one of the most memorable sounding songs to me, is that song. The one that's not necessarily catchy, but most memorable. But once again, they I like the art overall, but this comes in a lot of colors. You can get brown, orange. Orange still available. Maybe obvious reasons, I don't know. Brown and orange, and I think they had a mixed color. But you know, I thought the silver looked.
It's supposed to be silver. It looks kind of silverish.
It's clear silver, so it's kind of a gray. And it shines more in the without light shining through it.
So. Right.
On this is a 45. I just bought a Pro-Ject. What is it? Pro-Ject. Pro-Ject Carbon DC. And upgrade stereo. That, if you're going to start upgrading your stereo, go to that. But that one in particular, now most albums are 33. This is a 45 for some reason. Only reason I can think of for having put this on a 45 is for the bass. Slayer sounds maybe even better than this recording. I don't know any reason why they needed to put this on a 45. It's only 45 minutes long. So to make me take the top off of the platter off my turntable and switch my belt to 45 because I don't have a switch on it. If they're gonna start putting 45s out, yeah, you get the one that you got a switch on it, you know, take your platter off. It's so hard work, you know.
You might as well just pick up the Star Wars 45 version, is what I'm saying.
There is no reason for them to put this on two albums that I can think of. So I don't, you know, the Slayer is a gatefold and it looks awesome. I don't, you know, because there's two songs on each side until you get to the last song, and they put a song I don't even need to hear. So, three songs on the last side, so that's not cool. So the way to listen to this, get the CD, you know, I mean, get the album if you want to get the album. But
for collector's purposes.
Yeah, that's the only reason to get this on vinyl, because they're not going to send you a download card. Get the freaking CD, you know, because...
Really?
Two songs?
They didn't send you a download card.
Okay, there's two, three. No, they don't send download. You know,
really?
Nuclear Blast is probably more music.
On. Come on, Nuclear Blast. Shame on you.
Especially since you're spending, you know, I'll go to another label. And I'll go to another label and the album will be cheaper and have a download card. So yeah, that's not cool. But
musically wise, though, overall, this album's probably, like I said, probably second favorite. Production's great on it.
Second favorite to what?
To the Slayer
of these, yeah,
of all the ones we've listened mentioned here today. Testament, it's a good album. It sounds like Testament. Alex plays fabulous, Mr. Skolnick. Like you said, Chuck is Chuck. Eric Peterson, he's been with the band since the start.
This is Eric Peterson's album,
so yeah, if you're a Testament fan, this is one to pick up. Definitely.
Yeah, I would definitely say it's not bad. It's solid. And nobody put out a bad album. And so they all stepped up to the plate. And
right.
It's kind of interesting that all these bands put out something, you know, within a year.
Right.
And so it was kind of cool in that way, and it's kind of cool also that they all, including Metallica, you know, especially Metallica, stepped up to the plate too.
You know, the thing is all these bands and all these albums we talked about, they're all 30 years old or more. You know, they've been putting out albums for 30 plus years. So you know, if you take that into consideration, you know. If I was a teenager in the 80s, you know, these guys have got to be in their 50s.
Yep.
I believe 50s to upper 40s now. You know, all of them. And they're still doing it, I guess is what I'm trying to say, you know.
And doing it well.
And doing it well.
In some cases, almost better. In a lot of ways, better. Because they know what they're doing, they have better equipment, they have...
Right. And they've got 30 plus years of experience under the belt.
Yeah, so, I mean, yeah. You like somebody, and it's usually because of what you're introduced to, what they introduce, you know. Otherwise, right. You wouldn't like them, you know.
Right.
So, there's always that.
Right.
And so, it just makes it good when they...
Step up to the plate.
Yeah, and they actually do something to get the handle. So yeah, it was a good year for metal, and a good year for thrash. And I think we're going to hear a lot more. We're definitely going to hear a lot more this year. And you know, I know all these guys are going to be touring this stuff. I'm not sure about Slayer, but...
Oh, yeah. Slayer's on tour now.
Are they? So...
Slayer's on tour with Testament and Kirkus.
I haven't decided whether to get...
that weird.
Metallica tickets, since they're going to have to cost, what, $666 per ticket?
You know? Something like that, yeah.
So... But I am going to Iron Maiden, finally.
So you can get your fill at 656.
So yes, it was the year of the beast. So, anything else?
That's it.
This probably is too long. I don't know if anybody's still around, but
God, these guys are going on and on and on. Shut the pie hole.
Pretty fucked these albums anyway. So, anyway, all right. Thanks for watching. Leave some comments below. Subscribe. Check out Eric's videos or whatever on your music.
Just playlists right now.
Playlists on right. How do you find it?
Doomsayer 2001, just on YouTube.
Maybe I'll put a link if I remember.
Right. I just put playlists together, what's catching my ear. Some old, some new. Just whatever.
Yeah.
Mix it up.
Lots of heavy.
Lots of heavy, yeah.
So,
lots of jam.
Next time we'll do some more heavy. And so anyway, the salt and you forgot his name. Eric.
Eric, was I supposed to say my name?
Check you next time.
Later.